Welcome to God Lovers Are All Vegan, interview with Reverend Father John Ryder, vegan, part 2 of 2. I am a Christian, therefore I am vegan. This powerful statement was coined by the Reverend Father John Ryder, a retired parish priest of All Saints Church in God's Hill, Isle of Wight, England. The respected father is also a spokesperson for Christian Vegetarians and Vegans UK, an organization that defends vegan Christians for their benevolent plant-based diet, inspires other spiritual people to follow suit, as well as sets shining examples to the world that true followers of Jesus are always vegan at heart. Father John Ryder was brought up as a Christian and in an animal people loving family. Gradually, his compassion grew to the point where he could not bear the killing of animal friends for meat. Thus, as newlyweds, he and his wife became vegetarians and subsequently full-time vegans. Since then, the Reverend Father John Ryder has never strayed from his lifelong path to promote veganism. Intelligent viewers, in the previous episode, Father John Ryder talked about the spiritual aspect of veganism in Christianity. On today's show, he will continue sharing with us his wisdom from a lifetime engagement in promoting veganism.
I think if people were aware of the suffering in meat production, the majority would not eat meat. They deliberately do not want to know. When you tell them, they say, "Don't tell me, I don't want to know." I think that is being duplicitous, hypocritical, to think that I want to enjoy myself because I don't want to know what suffering I cause. It's totally irresponsible. You should try to know what you cause, what effect you're having on the world. In reading Albert Camus, The Plague, and other such like writings of his, it is very interesting that the doctor, one of the doctors in The Plague, says, "I try as much as I can not to cause any suffering, and where possible, to do some good." Now, I think that is what all people should be told, that in their whole life, you've got to work hard not to cause suffering. Very few people do much good. And if we are not going to cause suffering, we certainly cannot eat meat. If you give a pig the same opportunities as a child, until the child is 5, the pig will win on any computer game. Yes, we do after the age of 5 get further, but you wouldn't treat a child just because they're under 5 the way we treat animals. Most people don't realize, understand the feelings and intelligence of animals because they're too narrow-minded and bigoted from their own point of view and don't think of the other ways things happen. But if you think a bird can navigate from one end of the world to the other, back to its same nest, the other side of the world, it's a lot better than any human can do without instruments. And in so many ways, animals are as intelligent, but it's also obvious they can feel pain in the same way, they can feel fear in the same way. And this is one of the extra reasons why factory farming is so unhealthy, because of the fear and pain that the animals feel, there is so many unhealthy hormones that are then pumped into the meat.
Most of the time, Father John Ryder prefers a gradual approach in promoting the plant-based diet. However, he is sometimes surprised by how quickly an awakening person can transform.
Yes, to try and get people to see this, one has to take the opportunity of when something else is being discussed that they're interested in and pointing out some issues that they can think about it. When I used to do frequent school assemblies, I always used to try to hear from the teachers what the themes were for that week, so I could use what the kids were talking about and thinking about anyway to lead them on to another step. And this is also what one's got to do with expanding people's sympathies to include animals, is to wait until there is that opportunity in what they're talking about, what they're thinking about, to put in some extra information, to put in different arguments, to try to get them to see that animals have as much feeling as they do. Well, I suppose I could mention my son-in-law, who, when he got married to my daughter, was a meat eater and is now probably more doctrinaire vegan than she is. And that was made interested in this matter through my daughter, but then through seeing a documentary on television about the suffering of animals in farming. So people do change. Sometimes his was quite traumatic, but sometimes it is just a little step at a time. So what I think is most heartening to see is the vastly greater number of people who are vegan.
While engaging with meat eaters, besides spiritual aspects, Reverend John Ryder also blends in scientific facts to support veganism.
The benefits to health of a vegan diet is far, far less cancer. Some cancers aren't much affected, but most cancers are almost unknown in vegetarians and vegans. Heart health is vastly better, as well as diabetes is almost unknown amongst vegetarians and vegans. Doctors always talk about a Mediterranean diet, and that is largely what vegetarians and vegans eat, is plenty of unprocessed oils, unsaturated fats. The health benefits in terms of longevity and general health, as say with cancer, heart and diabetes especially, are the ones I know of, are very high. So most of the things the doctors tell you to avoid are found in meat, not in vegetables. The greatest thing any individual can do to help the environment to stop or slow down climate change is to stop having meat and dairy. There are other things, perhaps larger things, which the governments can do. But what an individual can do, the most important thing is to become a vegan or move in that direction as fast as they possibly can. There are other things that would help too, of course. We should be trying to do everything we possibly can to slow down climate change, in what lights one uses, what car one drives, what traveling one does. But the most significant change will be becoming vegan. For a person who eats the amount of meat and the average Western eats, the pollution they cause through a car is insignificant by comparison. It's not to the point to bother about anything else unless you're worried about what you eat. That is the main driver of climate change. And Al Gore, in his campaign, showed that very clearly. I have his video somewhere in my library on it. That was very clearly done. And recently it's come out in the news as well that the main thing people should do is to stop animal agriculture and to plant trees instead. To stop climate change in general and all these destructive effects is to stop eating meat, because the production of meat is what drives all these horrible things. Yes. It uses so much more water as well, so much more land. We just don't have the land. If everybody in the world tried to eat what the average Western person eats in meat, half the world would starve, because there wouldn't be enough food and there wouldn't be enough space to grow that food. So there's got to be a change from that point of view as well. If you're concerned about humans, you will not eat meat.
At the close of the interview, Father John Ryder shared his concerns about the church and its approach to veganism.
The church's attitude towards this is improving. Far too slowly, but it is improving. I would say in the last 10 years, the more positive statements coming from both the Church of England and the Church of Rome in dealing with animals has improved vastly over their attitude before, that sentience is being acknowledged. Animal sentience is being acknowledged, that the wholesale carnivorous diet is being seen as a problem. So I think things are improving. More and more bishops are coming out as themselves being vegetarian or vegan. And so I do think that things are getting better, but nowhere near fast enough. I think the change in society is one of the things that is growing there, and it is something which I'm trying to push as well, that you are going to be declared irrelevant by the majority of young people unless you promote veganism, because the younger people are more and more seeing the necessity, and just in terms of climate change, even if they don't have a heart for animals, they're seeing the necessity in terms of climate change. And if the church pushes against this sort of thing, they are going to be declared irrelevant. So if they want to keep up with this, they, even if they do not condemn meat eating, they do need to encourage a plant-based diet to as great an extent as they possibly can. I think they are moving in that direction, but I think the rate at which they're moving is speeding up. Unfortunately, not as much as I would like it.
We sincerely thank the Reverend Father John Ryder for sharing his wisdom about the connection between compassionate living and Christianity. May people of all religions join in to create an elevated vegan world filled with love, peace, and harmony for all beings. For more information, please visit christian-vegetarians-vegans.org.uk.